It's good to see you all guys inside the course. So this is basically an introduction video. In this video, we will talk about React Native and we will see the difference between Expo and React Native CLI. So let's get started. So basically React Native is a technology to build app for both Android and iOS with a single code base. Now by doing this, maintaining the app became easier as both app has a single code base and also cost is reduced. Because now companies don't need to hire two teams for Android and iOS. Only one team or one person can make app for both Android and iOS using React Native. Now let's talk about little history of cross-platform mobile app development. So this React Native was not the only one which came into the market with the idea of cross-platform mobile app development. The first one which came into the market was Cordova. But the problem with that was we got a low performance for larger app as app built with Cordova were hybrid app. Now hybrid app are those app which are basically wrapped inside a native container and looks like a real app. And then came into the market the Ionic, which was built on the top of Cordova, but still the app made with Ionic were hybrid app. Then came couple of others like Xamarin Native Script, but they didn't gain much popularity. Then came this React Native, which was developed or which is developed and is maintained by Facebook. But app built with using that are not hybrid app. Now they are native apps. Now Facebook says that they are native apps, but let me give you an example. Let's say we made a button component that converts into native code, but when we click on it, it actually fires a JavaScript function. Now we can say that they are close to native app, but they are not truly native apps, but we don't get any performance issue with that. App made with React Native are super fast, super fast. Now there is a technology that is giving that is introduced by Google, which is giving tough competition to React Native, that is Flutter. Now this Flutter has a very different approach. What it does, it directly accesses the graphical layer and renders pixel on it. Let me give you an example. Let's assume PUBG, the game, right? The game is built in, let's say Flutter. We are assuming that. I know it's not built in Flutter, but let's assume. Now that PUBG looks like identical in iOS as well, right? And it's look identical in Android as well, right? So this is, so Flutter takes this approach of game development engines, right? So it directly accesses the graphical layer and renders pixel on it, right? So apps look identical on both iOS and Android, but React Native doesn't do this, right? React Native converts the code into its respective native code. Let's assume the WhatsApp is built in React Native. I know WhatsApp is not actually built in React Native, but let's assume for now. Now the WhatsApp app looks like a Android app on Android and it looks like iOS app on iOS, right? So yeah, so these are basically difference between, right, other technologies, right? So you know, React Native and Flutter both are great. You can get started with any one, right? There is no comparison. Both are amazing. Both apps built with both are super fast, right? And both are close to native applications. Yeah, so there is no comparison. It's like we are comparing Django with Node.js. Now Python developer will say, hey, Django is best, and JavaScript developer will say, hey, JavaScript is best. So you can just pick whatever you like, right? We are picking React Native because we are JavaScript developer, right? And we love JavaScript. That is why we are using React Native. And if you already know JavaScript, I would recommend just go with the React Native. You will love it. You will love it. And it is easy to get up and running with React Native if you already know React. Okay. Yeah. So I think it's enough of the theory. Now, if you want to make native apps in 2020 and let's say in future, just go with React Native. Either React Native or Flutter. Both are amazing. Right? Okay. So if you click in here, get started, and this will open a little. Here we can see we have two ways of getting started with React Native or by installing React Native into our system. One is this Expo CLI and this is React Native CLI. Let's now learn the difference between the both. So I have made a little PDF kind of a thing. Let me fit that to my screen size. Let me just wait for a second. Okay, yeah, now let me little bit zoom onto this. Okay, so the first difference is between I have just made this PDF kind of thing to just make you understand what are the exact differences. So basically in Expo we don't have access to native code. In this React Native CLI we have access to native code. The native code is like the Android folder, the Java code in Android, and let's say Swift code in iOS. And the second difference is Expo really makes the development process smoother. Just by scanning QR code, all we need to do is just scan a QR code, and the app will get up and running on our real device without connecting any kind of a wire with the PC. Yeah, so it really makes the development process smoother. Now on React Native CLI, development process is not that straightforward and smoother because of the Android Studio, messing around with the Android Studio, right? And Expo is good for small app and for learning purpose. It's great for experimenting with the things for the learning purpose. Yeah, and this React Native CLI is good for, let's say, bigger application. Now let's assume that you are making a bigger application and you want to use a specific library, and that library is only available in React Native CLI. It's not available in Expo. So in that case, you should use React Native. In that case, you need to use React Native, right? And there is, let's say, you are making a resource intensive app. Let's say you are accessing camera, you are doing some stuff, heavy stuff, resource intensive stuff with images, you are rotating them, you are applying the video filters on that. So yeah. So these kind of things, for these kind of things, you should use this React Native CLI. Okay. Now the apps built with Expo have a bigger APK size, or bigger app size, you can say. Now right now we don't have any way to custom or reduce that APK size. Yeah, so this is kind of a disadvantage of Expo, and apps built with React Native CLI smaller in size. Now the advantage is of Expo is that it doesn't require Android Studio or Xcode. Yeah, so these you can build apps on low end machine as well, right? Just all you need to do is just scan a QR code and that's it. Your app will get run on your real device. Yeah, even you can build your app without using Android Studio. What Expo is will does is it will use their own server to build your applications, right? Yeah, so I think you can build app with iOS on the Windows machine as well, because you know Expo does it on his server, right? Yeah, I think I'm assuming I haven't tried, but I'm assuming that you can do. And also in React Native CLI, you need to have this Android Studio installed, right? Okay. But the main thing is the code part is almost same. The code is almost same. There is no change in logic, right? Both uses React, and it's almost the code is identical, right? Okay. Yeah. So for now, we'll be using this Expo CLI. And the only reason for that is it provides a smoother learning experience. Right, so since this is a beginner course, I don't want to mess around with Android Studio. Yeah, so I just want to focus on just learning React Native for the learning purpose. Right, once you know how to use apps with this Expo CLI, you can just use this React Native CLI as well, because there is no change in the logic, right? Just for now, what we want is we want to focus on just learning purpose, just learn React Native. That is the only purpose why we are using this Expo thing. Yeah, and since this is a course for beginners, so I don't want to confuse the people with using this React Native CLI. Yeah, although it's easy, but since I want to test those app, I want to show how to test those app, and I want to just make this process really easy, right? Yeah, so I'll be using this Expo for now, right? But once you learn how to use React Native with Expo, you can just go with React Native CLI as well. Now let's say you have made an amazing app with this Expo thing, right? Now you want to use a specific package or library that is only available in React Native CLI, but you have built app with Expo. Now what you can do in that case? Now in that case, there is a special command that is Expo eject. You can use this Expo eject to convert your Expo project into React Native CLI. Yes, it is possible to do. Yeah, so you can do that if you want to convert Expo project into React Native CLI. Yeah. Okay, so this is enough of the theory, I think. Yeah, so next part we will be directly jumping onto the code part, and we will have a lot of fun. So I will see you guys inside the course.